Bubby, are you supposed to be in the front of the house? Oh my goodness, you two are so cute in your matching reds.
Pardon me while I put on my cat brushing teeth gloves.
March 10. Oh my God. It's a Thursday, I think. The days are running together. It's what happens when you build double digit hours 3 days in a row, even though you're not traveling, which is difficult to do, but not impossible. But that's what happens when you have a lot of document intensive as well as writing intensive projects. And that's what I've been doing. So my mind is about ready to, well, my body's ready to jump out of its skin. And my mind is kind of jello. So I'm going to use that Cocker Spaniel body to hopefully do some physical activity today to make up for the past 3 days. Yeah. Anyway, so everyone have a great day. Love it. Laugh at it. And enjoy.
Update on Kitty Butt. She is now fitted with a glucose monitor so that we can keep track of her blood sugar now that she is a diabetic kitty.
She slimmed down quite a bit because of the diabetes before we got it treated. Now she's starting to plump back up and her hair's starting to look good. So there's hope on the horizon for my old kitty. She's 15 at the end of the month. She keeps me up all night. It's like having a newborn. So sometimes I wake up on the couch because I get tired of listening to her scratch to wake me up to feed her. But that's part of being a cat daddy.
Ooh, 6 hours after getting here and got the crap done that I said I wanted to get done. Just spent about an hour reading some medical records I didn't want to read, but part of the game. So want to warm up with some single buck to get the cobwebs out and then make this shit happen. Glasses, trying them out. I've also got a 35 inch white pine up there. That's bigger than what's on the series, but it's still what I would consider an 11 inch log. I've been climbing. First board, awesome. Second board, pussy. So if anything, I'm hoping that I can be a little bit more less of a pussy on the second board, and then really get into the top. And so if I could cut this at a minute, I think I'm doing pretty good because this log is dry as all hell. And I'm using what I would consider a demo axe, an axe I wouldn't use on the series, but a good axe nonetheless. You know, it cuts well. It's what I've been using in all the Champions Trophy races I've been doing. 52 and 28 hits. I hit the log on 27, so that's a PR for this spring, probably a PR for me for a while. I normally don't break 30 seconds. Now, if I can just keep on improving, you know, it's just, again, mechanics is what it's about. Beautiful pockets there. And Will Brook told me to step back on the top, on this bottom board, and really get those hits in hard. So that way I'm not cheating myself by getting too close to the pole on this first board. So props, Will. Thank you. Hickory up. So yeah, this is as hard as the hardwood's gonna get. This is what we make our handles out of, and it's really stringy. So I'm trying to go one up and one down instead of doing two up and two down, because it's only a 10-inch log. I had to put Bruce Winkle, you know, two up, and anything smaller than a foot, it's a waste of axe. So one up and one down, here we go. Absolutely ratchet. Those happen. I don't know why, you know. Very displeased with that, but yeah, move on. Make up for it later, hopefully. We'll see what happens. But yeah, just very disappointed with, just couldn't, I could, did not settle with that first hit. And then just after that, it's downhill. But anyway, part of it. Keep on moving. Even if standing block shit, at least the single's still good. So I've got a massive 15-inch underhand that was a little bit short. So like they did in Tassie, I had to, you know, someone with the who was block marking the logs got a little short. So this is one of the leftover logs from the WVU kids coming down. So I'm just gonna cut half and half, because I'm gonna do some stupid shit after this. Well, on the underhand, a little bit of double cutting, but on logs, that was actually 16 inches. It wasn't 15. But tulip is a hardwood. I was using a hardwood axe. And so very pleased with the way the scarves came out and the way I'm putting the axe on the wood. Like I said, a little bit of double cutting. And what that basically means is that you open your scarf up and then you try to maintain that angle all the way in. And you pick up a little bit of chip on the previous hit in order to keep it along that plane. And it's normal. You try to minimize that as much as you can in order to progress into the center of the log. Doing that is absolutely essential in hardwood because the axe is carried, and that's a hardwood, even though tulip doesn't carry the axe like most hardwoods. Time to get stupid. I got a little champions trophy race. Got a 36-inch pine in the standing. I've got a 40-inch pine in the underhand. So basically, they're Timber Sports Series size logs. And yeah, this is gonna suck. It always does. But I really enjoy it. So, what does that say about me? Minutes after that race, and so that one was a 203. It's now 218. Getting ready to do it. I've got this one's only a 38 inch log, so it's actually a smaller foot. This is the same log, just turned upside down. So, yeah, do some deep breathing. I'm retarded. It's like 15 minutes after doing that stupid shit. I've got a foot tulip on top of this tree, and I don't know where I'm going to find the energy to cut it, but I'm going to do it. This is all about mechanics and growing a set and cutting. I'm using a hardwood axe because this log's full of knots. This was cut out of above the forks of this tree. So this is just training. Just working on being smooth with the board mechanics and really chilling the log on top.